to set up my phone. Just give me a moment. A little bag of all the parts we finished. And so now we have a thing of all the parts that we haven't finished. So to start off, we'll be finishing up all of the shield bits and then working on the right leg. Once I'm done with the shield, the shield bits, I'm going to take all of the parts out and then organize which ones do and don't need any decals applied. So to continue the shield bits, you got to put them together. Because it just makes it easier to organize. Ah, it's music. Didn't know what that was. Okay, so that's those put together. We don't need any more parts on the little C, these smaller ones, so they can move off to the side for the moment. Now, this is done for... Yeah, both sides of each shield bit, 39. Yep, that's what's done. Okay, so. It might just be the one. Okay, so it's just the one on each one then. Okay, 39. So it needs to line up with that, so it goes like... That explains why I'm having problems with it. I haven't washed it yet. Oh hey Risk! How are you doing? I'm doing quite well today, how have you been doing? Fixing some stuff up, huh? Alright, that's been nice and cleaned off. Thank you. Okay, seriously, why does this thing just like randomly have astronaut transmissions? Okay, next up, 46, and if I'm correct, yeah, 46 lines up quite nicely with 39. Disorientation. Line the top of it up with 39. That's what that looks like. Add some white lines to it rather than it just being bare. So next up we do it the other side with 42 and 47. Now apply 47. That's what those two shield bits look like with all the decals applied. So with that, open up the bag of finished parts and put them inside. Now I'm actually going to pour out and organize every remaining bit into either needing to have decals or not needing to have decals. Body needs decals. Shoulder needs decals. The hands do not need decals. So gather all the hands. Including the ones that are currently on the arms. Yep. That's all the hands. The arms need decals. Shoulders, that bit need decal. The core, or like the GN drive, does not need decals. these two parts aren't needed, and that's another hand. So those all go in. These are the weird arms. These are spare parts. This is an equip part, and this is a spare part. This is a part for the stand, and this is a spare part. So all we have left to do are the arms, the shoulders. Oh, that's a spare one, so we don't need it. The arms, the shoulders, the body, and one of the legs. And one of the legs is like good and on its way. So today we'll do rest of this leg, and then the shoulders, and start on the arms if we have time. Yeah, journey's nearly over, absolutely. What's it called? Working through this has been great, but after... I check because I upload it to YouTube channel to like store it all. I'm very happy to be done after... This is part 11, so it's probably going to be 12 or 13 when we're finally done with this thing. Much as I love it, pain to build. So then... The right leg, what stickers do you need? My plan after... there's this thing I found on eBay, which is like 30 bucks, and it is a bunch of... It's a stand, and I'll try to find a better one, because it's currently a clamp stand, so I'd have to put it on the side of the table. And it has six arms, and then one arm that like comes over, or like it's like... You know Octavius's arm tentacle robot things, like can change with a bajillion different joints? Yeah, it has a bajillion different ball joints, and each of them have an alligator clasp on the end, but that's rubber coated in order to be able to safely hold like parts of stuff. So I'd be able to use it to hold a Gundam, and then that other arm that comes over is a magnifying glass and light, so I can use that to look at the instructions and do like work on the parts without having to like constantly pick them up out of camera view. So I'm gonna get that. This little kit, which comes with not just nippers, but a part separator, a file, and like a thing for grabbing the stickers better, because my fingers aren't very good at it. I literally want to cut my nails, but I can't because I need them for the stickers right now. They are getting pretty bad. And after that, then I just wait, see if a Gundam kit catches my eye. But other than that, I'm going to be saving up, because at the end of the year, a couple new kits are coming out, and so I'm wanting to grab one of them, or at least one of them. If they are re-releasing the old build series, there's a couple of those that I'm wanting to grab. So... Probably just gonna be another large hiatus from me not having anything to build. There's like, I still need to build like a, there's a proper stand for this guy that I got, and like some other stuff, make a proper diorama, but other than that, not much Gunpla planned. So I guess I'll just catch up on shows and beat Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom. Alright, let's clean all the parts on the right leg that need cleaning. That is here, which gets 22, here, which gets 21, here, which gets 28, here, which gets 23, and here, which gets 29. Then there's this part, which gets 23 and 24 of the darker reflective ones. Now we go back over, dry it all off. Something that I love in the new Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom, which isn't a spoiler, so don't need to worry about that risk. Whenever Link is cooking, he hums a little tune to himself, and the tunes will be like songs from the past games. It's like he'll hum Epona's song, which is like part of the Lon Lon Ranch song. He'll just hum that to himself while cooking. He hummed Song of Storms once when I was cooking. It's like he hums all sorts of different little tunes while he cooks. Alright, 22. Oh, it is just so much fun to play Tears of the Kingdom. Would absolutely recommend it. Someone actually built a Gundam in Tears of the Kingdom. The Banana Gundam, as they called it, because the Yiga clan love bananas. And essentially, it is a weapon of absolute and mass destruction made using Ultra Hand, which just lets you make all sorts of vehicles and stuff. And they can just go around and destroy everyone. Somebody used beam emitters and the stuff that makes stuff fly and whatnot in order to make an orbital laser, which just shoots things from above. Like the stuff some people are making is insane. And eventually, like, someone's gonna make something overpowered for speedrunning, and it's just gonna become a speedrun strat. To, like, rush with all your might. To build a certain construct, and then just use that to win the game. Alright, there we go. Now we get 23. Goes up the very tippy top. Next up, 23 and 24 of the shiny ones. Because of where it needs to go, 23 is pretty hard to apply. 23 and 24. So I'm gonna be very glad when they're out of the way forever. So essentially, it goes in this little gap here, as you can see, the little bit that's not blue, it's reflective, except the leg blocks off, like, access to that spot, so it's incredibly hard to get them in there, like, without the proper, like, thing to hold the stickers, just using your fingers, it is very difficult. So that was a pain. So that's the front of that's the front of the right leg done forever now. The sides have already been done because there's very little done to the sides. And I messed up that one sticker, so that's the sides done. So now I just need to do the back. And then I'm done with the legs entirely. We'll be one step closer to being done. So to do that, all the points where stickers are applied, which is here, here, and there, which has already got its sticker applied. Dry that off. Which means there's only two more stickers to apply. Those stickers are 9. Oh no, I put 9 where 29 was meant to be. Get it off. Okay, I got it off. Gonna put it 29, or put 9 where it's meant to be first. Okay, is this orientation new? No, so this way around goes up here. Apply some pressure so that it holds, because it's gone into a weird shape. It's like bent up a little. Not perfect, but quite well done. So now we just apply the teensy tiny 29 into that spot. And perfect. perfect Amundo. Well, slightly tilted, but good as I can get it to be. And you can't see it at all, but yeah, we've got 29 in there. 9 up here, 15 here. And that one shiny one. That means that the entirety of the legs are complete. Before we go on to the shoulders, just for satisfaction's sake, I'm going to separate the body and the waist. There's a ball joint. And I'm going to slap them together right at the end. Okay, that does not feel like it's meant to come apart. Well, plus I mean, because I don't want to accidentally break it. Okay, yeah, no, it doesn't come apart. Okay. Good thing I checked, because, yes, it really is not meant to come apart. Just got to reset this now, because it's a bit wonky. There we go, much better. This goes back in there for now. Now we are on the shoulders, and these two are fun. They just have some big stickers which are slapped on and then you're done. Oh no, there's actually two small ones. What's this? Huh? Oh, part fell off the body. That's right, it slides over. Like this. There we go. Push it forwards a little bit more. Then bring it down. There we go. Nice and fixed. Okay, shoulders. Left shoulder first. Is, yep, this one. 21 is applied to both sides, 21 of the shiny stickers. Take 21 and apply it into a spot on both sides. Where's 21? 19, ah, here it is, 21. And there's a little rectangular spot for 21 to go into nicely. those two little shiny stickers on the sides of it. So now, left shoulder has two. Yeah, so the left shoulder has two stickers applied to the front of it, which has it facing this direction. Yep, just wet the spaces where those go on. Then we attach 11 up the top along the angle. Yep. Okay, there we go. There's that one all nice and proper. And now we get the other one, which goes right down the bottom, and it is 28. Based on the number of stickers left, based like the tiny ones, and the number of parts left to apply stickers to, I get the feeling that there's going to be a bunch of like spare stickers or decals, which then I'm just like going to go over and, because like a couple I've skipped because I messed up the stickers, like with the right foot or the right leg. So this is what the shoulder looks like with those two stickers applied. Can't see it too well, but yeah, got those two on there. Now we go over to the far more interesting right shoulder. Who has... Yeah, so this one has 28 on both sides. Wait. Okay, so this one's also meant to have 28 on the other side, not 11. So I'll just quickly do that. Get the spot nice and wet. Dry off. There you go, good and proper. Then... grab 228 there by accident, so I'm just gonna put one back for the time being. There's 28 applied to the other side, which means that left shoulder is completed. Now, 28 is applied to both sides. Then on both sides we get 32, and then 35 and 33, 34. Okay. So we'll do both 28s first. So I know what I'm doing there. But we'll just, you know, clean every part that's going to get used. Side's dry. This side's dry. Now that the whole thing's dry, just make sure it's all, yep, properly clipped in. Now we'll grab the 2/28. Get our needed. Applied on one side, grab the other 28, and apply it to that side. So now I've got the 28s done, you can see they're just in the corners there. Next up, we get 32. Immediately lose it and refind it. This is 32, so it attaches to this side. Definitely lines up there, yeah, it lines up there. Okay, that's that applied. Then we grab 33. Doing it the correct way around, we line it up to the bottom one. Needed to go in a little bit further, it was a bit too far out. Basically perfect. It's got that line going along it now. So then we apply 34 and 35 to the other side in order to complete the look. Taking it from the top. Line it up like that. Then we get 35. It applies onto a... Yeah, this is correct. That applies just on there. That means that we've done the two shoulders as well. Just gone through the... Yeah, now we've only got the arms and the body to do. The body's the big one, so we're going to do the arms for now. We'll definitely be able to fit that into the stream. And then next stream will likely be us finishing the body and whatever stickers we haven't done previously. And then finally slapping it together. So starting with the left arm takes 1, 2, 3, 4 stickers on the front, 2 on the back, and none on the side. So that's a total of 6 stickers. That's not too bad. Get that properly wet, and then apply it to all the parts where stickers are applied. Which is there. There. And there. There. Once that's been properly applied and dried, we will get onto the stickers. So, dry. Dry. Yeah, those are all dry. Now the bit in there. That's nice and dry. Now we start off taking one of the 217s of the shinies, which are big long ones. Man, this would have been infinitely harder had it been magnetic. It's just difficult because I'm not good at this. Seems a bit too long, if I'm being honest. Oh, okay. I need to rotate the arm back. I had it like this in its normal position. A bit too far forwards. Still didn't have it far. Oh wow, it just came apart. Anyway, this will be a bit easier to apply it all the way back. use this bit to just make sure it's all properly aligned and done. Bend it back up a bit. Make sure it's properly applied and done up. Oh, there's a part which it didn't go in. Get in there. There we go, nice and proper. Or not. Me think this one's gonna be a pain if I don't take it apart a little in order to get it properly in there. Now we just reattach all the parts that I took off a moment earlier. As you can see, there's a shiny bit in there. Tucks inside where the parts are attached and stuff, so it's a bit of a pain to do. But it works, it works. Alright, that is one of them done. Next up is that one goes onto the blue bit on the wrist that's just goes on here. So now we get 8. It applies onto the front, arrows facing upwards, and it goes like. So that's what that looks like, got that on there. Next up, we apply 29 to the white part up the top. There it is. Grab the wrong arm for a second there. We apply it just above the line. This got that sticking up there, one down here, and the shiny one there. That's the entirety of the front of the arm done. So now, looking at the back, we wet this part. And really wet. Now we dry them off. Seven. Yep. And then 22. 27 are these small blue bits down the bottom. It is applied here. Like so. Then 22 is applied up here. That's what that looks like. Got the two little decals on there. And if I'm correct, 23 to the front. Definitely 23. Yep, definitely 23, which is a smallest one in the kit. In the kit, so it is lovely to apply. Yep. Got that on there. As you can see, it's a little blurry, but it's almost that white part. That means that the left arm is completely finished. And going for an hour means we've got 6 minutes, or well, we'll just finish off this one first. Then we will be done with the arms. Then all we'll have to do left is the body and whichever ones we missed. So, nothing there. One, two, three on the back, and three on the front, so six total. Yep, seven total, four on the front. So the first thing that we need to do is take apart the arm. Yep. Then we just need to split this part. Having that part separated right now would have been really nice. Just go back as far as it can. Now we just play Z Water. Excuse me for a moment, I need to go pick up a phone. Okie dokie, now we're back. So, starting off, we've got to clean this part. And then, so that's wetting it and drying it off. Nice and easy peasy. Next up, we grab 17. Get it nice and properly in there. Make sure it goes in that little space that you need the part open for. Yes, this part was definitely meant to be applied before putting the arm together. Didn't do it back then, don't know why. I think we put it together then realized it needed that. So now we've got that nice and in there, so we can put the arm back to how it was before and then put it back together. Which means this goes there. That goes here. This goes on, making sure the larger side plugs into the back of it. And then it has this plugged into it facing distraction. There we go. And that is the arm back together. There's this big gap in the back of the arm. Just like, this is the arm, this is back of the arm. It seems like something's just slotting though. Now the arm just folds into that part. I must say though, it does seem like something plugs into like these parts. I'll have to look into what's meant to plug into that. Going along the back. 22, 10, and 20 of the shiny ones. So we will start with those. With that shiny one. Making this part nice and wet. And now, 20. This little reflective bit down the bottom. Then we wet the rest of it just to clean it off. Then we dry it off. Clean the arm bit, which we'll be applying a sticker to as well. Got that nice and applied. Finally, 22, and it goes right up the top of the white part of the arm. That links into the shoulder bit. make sure it's in the proper alignment. And position. Then hold down because I accidentally made it so that it bends. There we go. This is what the back of it looks like with the decals applied. Got decal there, and a decal up here. So that's the back of the arm done. So now we just need 8, 23, and 29 for the front. Did, but I'll just re-clean all the parts we're using because I'm a bit over the top about it. And it doesn't do any harm. I'm aware of it shouldn't do. I hope not. So now 8 goes down on the wrist. Next up, 23 goes just before the elbow. Okay, and so finally we get 29 up the top of it. That one disappeared to the ether. Oh wait, no, there it is. Alright, so that stick is busted. For whatever reason, it won't stick, so I have to grab another one. There we go. Now with that done, both of the arms have been completed. Water, and now planning. So, I'll do the sides and back of the body now, because that's pretty easy. So that's, yeah, sides and back of the body will be very easy, and then the front of the body is what we'll finish off with, as it has 1, 2, 3, 4, only 4 stickers to apply to the front. Alright, well, that can be done when like on the final stream where we slap it all together and pose it. I was still expecting that to be a bit more. That's seriously it. Well then, with the back now facing us, we clean this part of the skirt. That's right, Risk. We're getting closer and closer to being done. It's likely just going to be the next stream, which is likely going to be tomorrow, so. Okay, now we need 18. It's likely that we're going to be like completely done with this thing tomorrow. As much as I would love that, Risk, I wouldn't ask that of you. I'm fine with like getting them all myself. It's a very nice offer, but at the same time, I'd honestly just feel bad if you sent me a kit. Gotta wet the two side bits of the skirt. To both sides of the skirt. Okay, so while I'm probably not gonna take you up on that offer, I am curious as to what you mean by receive half a kit. The sides and the back of this dude done. You know what? Let me just run this back. Oh, wait, no, two more to the sides. And then finish up for the night. Day. Whatever. Door. Now dry it. There we go. And we apply 28 in there on both sides. I've actually already finished building it. The 00 quant full saber real grade. So now applying all the decals and absolutely suffering. Because... oh my god, these things are tiny. And I do not have the proper tools. I plan to save up a bit and then splurge on like tools for building Gunpla. But I don't have them right now, and thus I am dying. Oh, hey, Ritz, what we were just saying, we'll start somewhere. I'm just gonna nickname you Charm. Which Gundam did you nab? So I'll finish up the stream for the night now that we've gotten the... okay, so you can barely see it, the white one there. I'm sorry, your first Gundam is a real... may your soul rest in peace with your first being a real grade, because... hoo boy, you're in for a tough one. For now, I recommend, you can try it if you want, like applying this all every single decal, but I didn't apply the decal on my first few Gundams because, yeah, real grades can be tough at first. I did a couple before I got my first real grade, so I was a bit more prepared, so I'm not sure what it's like going raw, but it will be an experience. So I wish you all the best. Surprisingly enough, I actually wouldn't recommend an entry grade for your first build. Specifically because I haven't done one before and thus I can't... obviously, like, it's probably the best one. But yeah, entry grade, high grade was my first one. The high grade 00 Sky. And it was a lot of fun to build. And is actually... its upgraded form, the Sky Mobius, is the base of what I'm going to eventually make for my custom Gunpla. High grade or entry grade would definitely be the best to start out the hobby, since they're a lot easier to build than a real grade. Real grades have like an endoskeleton. You have to build the endoskeleton on the high grades, yet they're still somehow harder. There's just so much more detail in them. Is that done? Yeah, tomorrow we are, real grades have some really super tiny pieces. You should be fine, it's just, you're gonna end up with a bit of a learning curve right at the start. Yeah, I would suggest, like, buying a cheap entry grade or something just to get a figure of how it works before doing that. You don't have to, this is just, like, a recommendation, just, like, to be safe. Because I'm constantly screwing up. Risk... I would, yeah, if you have any questions, I would ask Risk, because I have learned a lot of things from him. One of the things I will teach you right now, because this is an informational stream, when you are building your Gundam, glass of water and a rag of some kind. Dip the rag in the water and then apply it to the parts that you're going to be putting stickers on. And then dry it off with, like, another part of the rag. And that will make it so much easier to apply the stickers. So, I will see you tomorrow, guys. Where... oh, God. This one as well. I trusted you. That music is from an actual song. It's a lo-fi version, meaning that is not copyright-free lo-fi for 12 hours. So that's lovely. It happened with the previous one, so I had to change which one, and now that one's betrayed me as well. Yeah, so I'll be finishing this bad boy up tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then. So yeah, definitely ask Risk for some advice, because he is very good at giving it, and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Risk, Charm, I hope you guys have a lovely day/night/whatever. Bye!